Geminis, let's go ahead and see what's going on. It's going to be for November 12th through the 14th. So only take what applies, leave the rest. If you need a personal or any vital information, it will be listed in the description. And let's get started. So, what's the general message for my Geminis and their spirit guides? Okay. So, we have the Badger, and it says, bring your life into balance. We have Archangels Mary and Sandalphone. I always struggle with this word. Sandalphone. Why I added an I? What's wrong with me? Sandalphone. I hope I said that name correctly. Anyways, with this energy, Spirit is bringing attention to... Spirit is bringing attention to the fact that a lot of you guys may have a life where it consists of like going with the flow, but not in a way where... Not in the way that you should, like in terms of just allowing things to flow naturally. But like when I say go with the flow, it's like a lot of you are just kind of like going where the wind kind of takes you. And Spirit is saying like bring balance to your life where, you know, some of you may be very career focused right now. So your main focus may be career, where in other cases, sometimes, you know, you may be more focused on your personal life and not focused on your career at all. It's like your life may be very much like, okay, whatever the circumstances is, my life is just that. When you guys may be needing to get more of a grip on that, like knowing where you're coming and going. Maybe even in your routine, if anything, it just feels like your energy's all over the place. Like some of you, your sleep schedule has not been consistently the same. If you're an entrepreneur or you work from home, like your schedule's insane and your energy's off. Okay, you can only produce the best of yourself from a place of balance. But moving into the reading, the present situation, I do have the Wheel. And with the Wheel here, this is actually positive. This is a turnaround in energy. This could be for better or for worse, though, at the same time. Usually, this is actually a sign of like positive turnarounds, though. Not really like a sign of negative things coming your way, but there's a change of events that's taking place. What's this change of events? Change of climate. Four of Cups. So where you guys have been dissatisfied, unhappy for some time, it's like Spirit is coming through and initiating a lot of personal changes within your own energy, and your outward existence will start to look different. So a good example of this is like you wanting to be a lot further ahead in life, right? This triggers you to make the changes where you've been sitting in dissatisfaction, because the Four of Cups is always the woman sitting down, being unhappy with what she has, and also not seeing what the universe is trying to give her. What I see for the recent past, I do have the Nine of Pentacles. There may have been a big focus on you and doing you, especially for my single Geminis. You may have been questioning like why you're still single, but then also kind of realizing that a lot of that may have a lot to do with you not being ready emotionally. So there may have been a big focus on money, doing like independent stuff. Even if you were in a relationship, it's like a lot of you may have wanted to just kind of do you. There may have been a lot of questions as to what's going to happen next in your relationship. And if you're still able to have an opportunity to be happy in this relationship, especially if there's been cheating instances or fighting between you two, or even internal conflict, just more so on your end or theirs. And then I forgot to mention present situation energy. This looks like also like a turnaround happening with some sort of ending that took place with a relationship. It's either you guys are dissatisfied with that, or you could be rejecting somebody who tries to come back around after some sort of ending. But what I see for the future with the Tower, this is you having to address some sort of unstable foundation here. This could be like a business not founded on the best foundation, where like clients aren't consistent, or a relationship where it's not a consistently, you know, happy go lucky relationship, or it's on the brink of totally being done if certain things don't change about the way things are running. Now the advice with the Ten of Pentacles in reverse, there's a need for you to make sure, for one, you don't have your family coming in, like meddling within your marriage or your relationship. That's for one, because I do see that for some of you. Another thing I'm seeing, some of you really do need to push for getting your own place to live, especially if you live with a spouse where you guys argue more than are happy with each other. At this point, all that's doing is just causing a lot of like strain on your family. This is also putting emphasis on like getting out of like a parent's home. Yeah, setting small goals for yourself as well. And not getting so caught up with like the long term that you lose sight of what your goals are. This is also resisting the urge to go back to, again, some sort of long-term relationship or connection with someone who's still attached to the person they had a long-term relationship with or children with. Now, challenge that may come up with the Page of Swords, this may be you having like this need to find out like what happened. You may have curiosity as to what happened with the relationship, why someone ghosted you, why something turned out like this, why something turned out like that. So the curiosity could be the challenge, like curiosity kills the cat. This could also be pettiness. This is tit for tat. Whether this is you doing it or this person, there may be pettiness that's going on to spite the other individual. Or the communication is like really bad. That's another thing I'm seeing. But outcome with the Six of Pentacles, this is you being in full acknowledgement that it's not fair for you to keep putting all your effort and energy out there just to get the bare minimum back. Whether that's in you texting, calling, trying to see someone, and they, you know, text you back every couple of days, to use that as an example, or like within your career, going above and beyond, doing everybody else's job, and then feeling like you're not getting paid for it, or not getting a raise or promotion for that. And for a lot of you, this may more so aggravate you, and you may be in question of what to do about it. It's just making sure, again, you overcome this, which is the Five of Swords. This is like allowing things to get into your head. This is also manipulation. Staying away from feeling manipulated that you have to keep giving to something that's like very inconsistent. And the cards just kind of flew out my hands, but this is what I see. I hope that this was helpful. If you took something from this video, definitely thumbs it up and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.